another important average current of a sinusoidal AC. Average current of how much this average current I am going to explain. So here the I am going to take here one sinusoidal wave is nothing but I is equal to I naught into sine omega t, because already we discussed E is equal to E naught sine omega t from this one, say according to Ohm's law. So E is directly proportional to I only. So here the from this one, this is sinusoidal, this is a time value on x axis at the current value. So this is a sinusoidal wave like this. So this at t is equal to 0 origin. So this is the half cycle. So this is a full cycle. So here to here. So here the peak current I naught positive. This negative peak current I naught, here also I naught. So this area both are same and equal. That's why here for one complete cycle, it means one complete cycle here to here, this area and this area equal and opposite. That's why delta Q is equal to 0. So I average should be is equal to delta Q divided by delta T. That's why this value also I average for complete cycle, I average current also 0. So what happened here, half cycle, what happened we are going to discuss. So average value of this AC, average value of this AC is, so we are going to talk about here the for half cycle only, full cycle 0. So for half cycle we are going to discuss, for half cycle here the mean value should be is equal to, mean value is nothing but average value only, is equal to 1 by delta t integral of I into dt t1 to t2. So here the half cycle nothing but 0, t1 is equal to 0, t2 is equal to half. So substitute here. So I average is equal to 1 by t by 2 minus 0 integral t1 to t2. T1 nothing but here the 0, t2 nothing but half time interval. So here the I nothing but I naught sine square sine omega t, substitute here I naught sine omega t dt, sine omega t dt. So here the this value I average should be is equal to this one nothing but 1 by t by 2 in this integral value I naught, you may write out of the this integral, that's why I wrote here I naught. So integral sine omega t, integral sine omega t nothing but minus cos omega t divided by omega. So here the integral, this a function, one is a function here, one more time variable function is there. So that's why this type of integral nothing but continue integral divided by differentiator of this function. So it means here I'm going to write so integral of sine of omega t dt should be is equal to minus cos omega t derivative of omega t, that should be is equal to minus cos omega t divided by only omega. So that's why I wrote this one. This is a mathematical formula. So here the 0 to t by 2, here the time function t is equal to 2 pi by omega, t is equal to 2 pi by omega, t by 2 is equal to, that's why I wrote here pi by omega. Here also you may substitute. So pi by omega you may substitute. Here the average current is equal to 2 into I naught divided by t. This t we wrote here 2 pi by omega into minus higher limit nothing but omega into into T value is nothing but here T by 2 nothing but here the 5 by omega. So pi by omega, here the half term nothing but pi by omega. So divided by omega minus plus. So here minus cos 0. So here minus cos 0. You may put here the minus take out common, this minus take out common here. So I average should be is equal to minus 2 I naught divided by 2 pi by omega into here this omega get cancelled, cos 180 nothing but minus 1, here the cos 0 nothing but here also minus 1, this minus and this minus get cancelled divided by omega, this omega get cancelled, this 2 get cancelled. So here the final value 2 I naught divided by pi. It means here the average current is equal to in half cycle 2 I naught divided by pi. This is the formula 2 I naught divided by pi. So this is the formula. Based on this one they will ask numerical problems. Another important topic, RMS value of sinusoidal AC. RMS value of sinusoidal AC. Sinusoidal nothing but here the, so I is equal to I naught sine of omega t. So here I value on y axis, time value x axis, this is the origin O. So here the sinusoidal wave like this. So here T here the T by 2 T 3 T by 2. So here T by 2 T 3 T by 2. So in this way same here the peak value I naught, here the peak value minus I naught, here the peak value I naught only. So interval in this way, here the in RMS value of AC, whether half cycle or full cycle, both are same. Here the RMS value of AC, so half cycle or full cycle we are going to discuss. So here RMS value is nothing but here the I RMS should be is equal to under root of I mean square. So I mean square here we are talking about to 0 to T half cycle we are going to discuss. Whether half cycle or full cycle both are same. So I am going to take here the initial time 0, final. So T1 is equal to 0, T2 is equal to half time. That interval should be is equal to here. First I am going to find IMS, mean square current. I mean square, we are going to find. I mean square is nothing but 1 by delta T is nothing but here the T2 minus T1 integral of 0 to T by 2. Here the I square into dt. So this value substitute here 1 by t by 2 minus 0 integral 0 to here t by 2 I is nothing but here the I naught into sin square omega t into dt. So here this value IMS should be is equal to here the I square you may write out of the integral value. So here the I naught square divided by T by 2 is nothing but 2 I naught divided by T. So here the integral 0 to T by 2 is equal to pi by omega. And sin square omega integral sin square omega T into DT integral highly different. Integration. This one is difficulty. So that's why converting according to trigonometric formulas. So cos 2 theta should be equal 1 minus 2 sin square theta. Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Here theta nothing but omega t. Based on this equation, so here the 1 minus cos 2 omega t divided by 2 into dt. So here the, so this one get cancelled. So IMS should be is equal to, mean square should be is equal to I naught square divided by t. Here the integral 0 to t by 2 is equal to pi by omega into dt. Here the minus integral 0 to 5 by omega is equal to t by 2. Here the cos 2 omega t dt. This cos 2 omega t dt value should be equal to 0 because sine function. In sine function here pi by omega value you may substitute in sine function. Pi by omega value will give the 0 value. So here the final expression IMS should be is equal to I naught square divided by t integral into dt nothing but here the t 0 to pi by omega. This value substitute here I naught square into 5 by omega, t is nothing but 2 pi by omega, omega omega pi 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 cancel. So IMS should be is equal to I naught square by 2. I naught square by 2. This I naught square by 2 you may substitute here. That should be is equal to under root of I naught square divided by 2 is nothing but I naught divided by root 2. So it means here the IRMS value should be is equal to I naught divided by root 2. I naught divided by root 2. Similarly here ERMS is equal to also, similarly ERMS should be equal to also E naught by root 2. E naught by root 2. So here also where E naught nothing but peak EMF of AC generating source. AC generating source where E naught is called here peak value of AC generation or generating source. AC generating source.